Yo, everybody, we are back here again today for another exciting video. Today we are here with what may be the final episode of Mafia 3, and now this section of the map was not even accessible to us before this point. But here we are, you can see it over there, I believe in the distance. We get that music, the no going back music. So a few little updates here. I did a few upgrades off camera before I, made this drive over here. We can now hold 6 adrenaline shots at once, which is going to be super helpful. I made sure to I finished all the upgrades possible for our AR and our handgun, and I made sure to refill my ammo as well. I mean, this is the final fight, so I put pretty much all the money we had, all like however much we had left, into our character here. So we can now hold 6 adrenaline shots, which hopefully we won't have to use all of them. We now have a tack vest as well that I purchased. Took a little hit in a car crash earlier, so I lost a little bit of that, but that's fine. And here we are, the Casino Paradiso Hotel and Casino. And here we are, rolling up like we own the place. Find Georgie is the first section. Let's go. Okay. So Georgie's kind of far up here. These guys are, kind of in all the corners, which makes us tough. Okay, I don't really know what to do here. I think I'm gonna hit this left side out. So we pretty much lost our whole tack vest here.
I got this. Taking out the whole team.
All right, so we gotta pretty much run through this place until Georgie decides to, show himself. Nice. Whoa. So is Georgie down a floor? Yeah, looks like it. So Georgie's down a set of stairs here over on this side. So they bursted through these doors a second ago. But they regret doing that now. Come on. Keep coming at me. You guys having any regrets yet? Kill Georgie. Alright.
They say in Lincoln.
What are they saying about Lincoln Clay again? Sorry. Didn't really give the chance to hear that, but.
These motherfuckers can't protect you, Georgie. It's over.
Yeah, I don't know who he thinks these guys are, but. They would quite literally have to be clones of Rambo himself to be able to stop this angry Lincoln Clay right now. Come on. Whoa, well that's kind of unfair. Okay. That was definitely a little bit unfair, in my opinion. I don't know, man. It's fine. We'll just go at it again. See what happens. I mean, I am definitely running through it pretty quick, but like, why wouldn't I? Alright. We're good though. We still have our ammo. We still have our adrenaline shots. Alright. Okay. Let me make sure that I kind of stay over here now then. They're going to start bursting out of random doors and stuff. Yeah. Ooh. One of them does hit me. There's a guy up top there that I never saw before.
What you waiting for? Let's go.
I'm empty.
Come on. I don't know who you think you are, man. Georgie, you're just not gonna stand a chance against me, man. Just ain't no way. Okay, well, speaking of people that aren't gonna stand a chance, my pistol is cheeks.
That shit's all him. Form up a...
We're good still, though.
Say goodnight to the asshole.
Gotta hunker down.
Nice.
He's cutting us down. Okay.
More and more of them coming. Quite literally does not matter, though. We gotta get up the stairs now. Simple as that. Let's use a adrenaline here, since we, you know, have some right here beside us. Let's do this. We gotta get up a floor. These guys are up here in this little thing. I don't even know how to get up there. I don't know. How am I meant to get up there? Maybe go all the way around this way? I can't even go up that way. Okay. This is awkward then. Listen, buddy. Can I just, like... throw a grenade up in there? Well, that missed. I'm really confused as to how I'm meant to get up there. Or if I'm even meant to get up there. Back here.
One more kill for him.
Oh, wait, is this Georgie right here? No way!
Motherfucker.
I always thought you were my friend. That you had me and Ellis's backs. It was just an act. You didn't kill me because I said no. You killed me because you thought you owned me. Owned all of us.
It was never about us. About my old man. My father. I did anything for him. Same as you and Sammy.
And you understand why I have to do this.
Ooh. Making it slow. Yeesh. Okay. Right. So it looks like we're heading up to confront Sal.
Lincoln, but you're not. And you never will be.
Is it just Sal up there on his own? Oh man. We don't even need our weapons. Nice office, Sal.
Hell of a sight, ain't it? When I first come to this town, it was nothing more than a backwater shithole. Now look at it.
Let me see your hands.
Whatever was between us is over, you understand? It ended the second it was you coming up them stairs instead of my son. You want a drink?
All right.
I had this imported from Scotland. Single malt. Now, usually I'm a bourbon man, but I figured I'd order something with a little more class for when the casino opened. Not much of a chance of that happening now, is it?
Don't look that way.
Take a seat. I ain't going nowhere. Hey, not bad.
I think I still prefer Shine.
You know, a month or so after my brother Lucio died, I started having nightmares. I had this one where I was on a boat. A giant wave come, knocked my ass overboard. I hit that water and sink like a goddamn rock. Then there was another one where cotton mouths biting me all to hell. But the one that really got to me was Georgie's funeral. He's laid out in that shitty little casket. Neck cut, same as Lucio's. Yeah, that one really got to me. It'll come around again every 3 or 4 days.
That one where I'm back in Nam, sleeping in a foxhole. All of a sudden, these dark figures come out of the shadows. I try to fight them off, but they hold me down, tie my hands together, stuff a muddy rag in my mouth so I can't scream, can't warn the men sleeping next to me. And then I gotta listen as all those men die.
I would imagine that's not gonna go away anytime soon.
No. I imagine it won't.
And this. This was all to try to keep mine from coming true. Look how that turned out. I buried a lot of people. More than I can count. The one I never wanted to see go down in that cold ground was my son.
And yet here we are.
Yes. Here we are. My son is dead, and I'm having a drink with his killer. Now, I'm not gonna apologize for what I did, you understand? If I did, I'd just be lying. I don't have it in me to feel shame for the things I've done to others. Never have.
Didn't come here for an apology.
Nah. I know you did. Goddamn, I was right about you, wasn't I? I knew it the second I fucking saw you at the country club. Men like us, we're just wired up wrong. Only one thing we know. One thing we're good at. I'm gonna be waiting for you, Lincoln Clay. This won't be the last time we see each other.
I know.
What are you waiting for? Fucking do it.
All right. Oh. Out the window. And now all it says, leave the casino. Holy. Yeesh. We pulled a Tony D'Orazio on that guy right there, threw him right out of his own casino window. And that is pretty much the entirety of the Marcano family. Oh, like a light. What are we looking at here? Some pretty official looking cars coming down the drive. Uh-oh. Who's in the back? Wait, no way. Leo? Huh? My man's gotten old as hell.
I take it you're Lincoln Clay.
Oh my god.
So they tell me.
I told Sal this fucking casino would be the end of him. I meant it figuratively. This shit has a way of turning on you, doesn't it?
Especially if you piss off the wrong person.
You know who I am, son?
Guessing you're Leo Galante.
Take a little walk, you and me. Probably no surprise, but the rest of the commission wants you dead. You and anybody else that had anything to do with this.
What happened here was between me and Marcano.
Oh, I understand that, son. We all do. But this business makes you paranoid, irrational. They see Sally a pile of shit. They start wondering if someone's gonna serve them a plate of their own.
So you're here to decide if you're coming after me?
No. I'm here to deliver a message. You made your point, son. This all ends right here. Right now.
I got no quarrel with y'all.
Once a month, Sal kicked up 20% of his net. Cash only. Same man's been delivering it for, oh, I don't know, 20 years or so. I see no need in deviating from that, you?
No, sir.
In exchange, you run things as you see fit. Wanna sell heroin? Want a whorehouse on every other corner? Makes no fucking difference to me. Only thing that matters is 20%.
And what if I decide to walk away? Leave all this behind?
Then this will be the last time we see each other.
Huh.
Best of luck to you, son.
Alright, so Leo came in on behalf of the commission and let us know how it had to be. Honestly, pretty fair terms. 20% of whatever we make goes to the commission. They don't come in and try to take us out. And it looks like we may have one more mission to go here. Just one. Gonna go talk to Donovan and Father James. We'll see you guys once we get there. And we are here, guys. Meeting to talk to Donovan and Father James. Church bells are ringing. Oh, he has a really beautiful church. We've never actually been in here. Huh. Okay.
Is he dead?
Yeah, he's dead. Him and Georgie both.
It's the best news I've heard in ages. We get an amen, Padre.
So what happens now?
What do you mean, what happens now? It's over. Done. Finished.
I ain't talking to you. Just cause Sal Marcano's dead, Lincoln, doesn't mean it's over. Now what you did and the size of it all, you created a storm in this here city. And it's gonna take a long time for it to dissipate, if it ever does.
With Marcano dead, New Bordeaux belongs to me. Ain't nobody left to stand in my way.
You can't be serious. The point of this wasn't to replace Marcano, it was to remove him. This city's done gone through enough. It doesn't need another Sal Marcano.
This city? You've got to be fucking kidding me. This city is a cesspool. It's where people come to fuck and drink and get high.
You watch your filthy mouth.
It's what the city is, Padre. If it's not given another Sal Marcano, it's gonna shit one out.
He's right. If it ain't gonna be me, it's gonna be somebody else. Probably somebody worse.
Amen.
Hank. You remember what you told me when you came back from the war? How you wanted to go to California? Leave all this behind? And just start all over?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, it ain't too late, Lincoln. You can still go. Go! And don't look back.
Listen, I'd love to stay here and debate the merits of one crime boss over another, but I've got a schedule to keep. Bit of advice, though. The scumbags you've been working with, kill them. All of them. Bury them before they bury you, buddy. I'll be seeing you, Padre.
After Lincoln vanished, Vito Scaletta took over the city. I spit on Sal Marcano's grave one last time by actually doing what Marcano couldn't, finishing the casino.
Now, nice.
2 years later, Scaletta opened another casino, and then it was just an avalanche of development. Hotels, arenas, the new convention center. I mean, today everyone knows this place as the Las Vegas of the South, but the whole damn thing was built on bodies Lincoln Clay left behind with blood money he and his lieutenants stole from the mob. And Vito? He still lives in that penthouse at the top of Marcano's casino.
Yes, Vito.
Out of the city he owns.
Don't
After Sal Marcano's death, Lincoln Clay disappeared. The Bureau deprioritized the investigation after a few months, but I keep an active file. In 1971, I tracked him to a California shipyard where he was working under an assumed name. By the time we got there, though, he was gone. The trail went cold, and by 77, 78, I figured he was dead. But then I got a report of someone matching his description working with the Colombians. Since then, there's a new sighting of him every couple of years.
Langan made it out to California. Worked at the shipyards for a few years. Met him a woman. Seemed like he was gonna get married, but then it all came apart. Don't know why. And he started moving around. He went to Alaska, New York, South America. He even went back to Vietnam. I still get postcards from time to time. You know, I think Lincoln wasn't able to accept the world for what it is, or his place in it.
Someday, he's going to get tired of running, or make a mistake, and I'll be waiting. I promise you that.
Yeesh. And is that the end? That, ladies and gentlemen, is the end of Mafia 3. What a ride it has been. This episode was action-packed. And I think that, honestly, that couldn't have been at a better end. I mean, we take out Sal Marcano and Georgie, we take out the whole Marcano clan in a pretty good fashion, I would say. We get to see Leo again, which is probably one of my top 10 moments in the whole game. Then add another top 10 moment in seeing Vito up there at the top of the casino, running the city, finally getting the life that he really wanted, you know, the life that he deserved. And then, I mean, also seeing that, you know, Lincoln was able to mend things with Father James a little bit, and that's really wholesome as well. So I definitely think that we got the good ending, for sure. Again, the series was super fun to record, just like many of the other series I've been doing on this channel. Obviously, the Mafia series hits close to home for me, mostly just because I'd say it's probably been the most popular, you know, set of series that we've had. At least at the time of recording this, it's on track to do that. But I really, really do hope you guys enjoyed this episode. I hope you guys enjoyed this whole series. I hope you guys are super excited for everything that's to come on this channel. As always, guys, hope you enjoyed. And we'll see you in the next one. Peace out, guys.